Good morning, everybody. Hope you had a good night, and thank you very much for coming here to Virginia. For me also, I'm a bit new. End of the year, October, I took on the position as Vice President. Jörg Sommer is my name. Since then, we worked on a lot of initiatives, some of that you just learned about, and of course you know a long time about the BSUV to come. Today I really would like to talk about the initiative we took on the short term to move put the pedal down further into the metal and talk about model year 15 and the initiatives we did on across the car line portfolio, but specifically, as you heard from Scott, e-Golf, which we are really excited about, and Jetta. Talking about Jetta facelift first. Jetta is a very, very important car for us and for the group worldwide. We sold more than 1 million vehicles so far worldwide on Jetta. And as you heard, it's more than a third of volume sold in North America for us. And so the intent really was, with the facelift coming, to make that vehicle very competitive in its design, quality appeal, talking about interior. We did a lot of efforts in the interior to bring it up to a level of Golf, which is a very, very high level of execution and material and design appeal. And the next focus was on fuel economy and on crash. These are really the key areas where we need to compete, because that's also why the Jetta customer is buying us. Not only fuel economy in the segment is important, but also for the Jetta customer, safety and fuel economy are very important. Because that vehicle is so important to us, we have 5 powertrains in that vehicle. That's the most powertrains we have in all cars here in North America. And of course today, and you'll hear about it more, is the kind of star for us, the EA 288 TDI, which is a new engine now for Jetta, a clean diesel engine, but we also offer the natural aspirated 2-liter engine. We have the TSI 1.8-liter engine, and to come, the hybrid, and to come, the GLI for our enthusiasts. It's like the Jetta GTI, GLI, and it's a long-standing brand here in the US. Design you have seen maybe yesterday night already outside. We really aim to have a crisp, clean design and a wide premium appeal in the front. We changed the front bumper, the front lights, the grille, the rear trunk lid was changed, the lights were changed. We offer big xenon daylight running light, LED daytime running lights, and we have made some aerodynamic improvements also to the front grille and underbody of the vehicle. In the engine I talked about, important really is with the TDI, we achieve best-in-class fuel economy with 46 miles per gallon. And that outperforms basically the whole segment except some of the hybrids. We have a very good fuel economy with our TSI, 37 miles per gallon. And the hybrid to come has a 1.4-liter TSI engine in it. Next to the powertrain and the increase of power and improvement of fuel economy, we did great efforts in the interior. And I'm interested, when you drive the vehicle, what your takeaway is there. We changed really the whole driver-focused instrument concept here. We have the tubes, chrome, black gloss, paint. We also listened to our customers and dealers. We brought much more content down in terms of pricing. So we offer Bluetooth as standard, climate control, rain sensing wipers. And also we expect that Keyless Go, that function will be offered, as it will be offered at the entry level, will have a very wide high volume distribution in that car line. So really bringing down features in terms of price, making it more affordable, and bringing the quality appeal of the interior up was one big focus for us. And the safety concept. It's not yet tested. The IIHS will come later this month, but the vehicle, the body in white, was constructed to exceed existing standards. So we have very high expectations to have a highest ranking performance of the safety cell, the passive safety cell of that vehicle. In addition, we offer blind spot monitoring, rear traffic, front collision warning, park distance control, features which kind of build around that that safety story, which I think is very important for the positioning of the Jetta in the future. So that makes the Jetta really a truly very competitive offer, but also in day-to-day use. Trunk space, class leading with that vehicle. What is very much appreciated across all Volkswagens is that zippy drive feel, the responsiveness, the driving dynamics. Here we are class leading with power and torque very clearly in the segment. And that combined with the best-in-class fuel consumption performance, fuel economy performance with the TDI, I think makes the Jetta a truly class-leading, very attractive offer. In terms of pricing, attractive, as I said, value very important to make the vehicles not just at the top end attractive, but also price-wise, content-wise. We now added packages to our offer. We are starting at $16,215. We offer then at the entry level a technology package below $1,000 with a rear view camera, a premium radio, and the keyless access I talked about. And then we have the driver assistance packages and the lightning packages available for the top trims. But basically, that kind of pricing and trim lineup will offer us potential to play around in the model years to come in our offer. On the diesel side, the same story to be continued. Value in the entry cars, $22,740 with a very attractive content, and then the driver assistance and lighting package combined for the top trim. E-Golf. That's specifically interesting, or maybe I'm very proud of, because in my previous function, before coming to the US, and I've been here multiple times before, but I was running for the group, the e-business in the sales and marketing area for all brands in the Volkswagen Group. And e-Golf, of course, was one important pillar for that. We have introduced the e-Up in Europe. Now, this one is the first fully electric vehicle offered by Volkswagen in the US. And that vehicle, you have a chance to drive outside. Has a range between 70 and 90 miles, but what is really appreciated already in Germany when you launch the car are the features where you have the Eco Plus mode, where customers can modify the consumption and the performance of the vehicle and go up to 100 miles or more in range under ideal conditions. The good thing about the MQB platform is that in that vehicle you have no compromise. Normally a battery makes it difficult for packaging engineers to find really a good weight in terms of rear foot leg room or trunk space or the flat surface of a trunk. Here in the Golf, you have no compromise made, and it's fully functional like a real Golf, five-seater, no compromise on the luggage room, and that's because the battery concept was integrated from the beginning in the MQB platform, and that makes it possible. We have a 24 kilowatt lithium ion battery and 115 horsepower. And we have 199 foot-pound torque, which is really very, you know, a good feel to drive, and you have no compromise in making the traffic or the highway jump here. Talking about design, the C-shape LED headlights are first time here in the US for us, plus a signature light kind of design feature for the e-Golf. So it's very visible also when it's on the road with that kind of feature. It has a very good aerodynamic coefficient and also low resistance alloy wheels, low rolling resistance running alloy wheels. The powertrain is, I talked about the 199 pound foot torque, the 24 kilowatt battery. We produce, assemble in Germany, and the same with the electric engine. And that's really key for us, because with the electrification strategy of the Volkswagen brand and group, we feel very strong about that competence of building and assembling electric engines and batteries needs to be an in-house competence. And that's why we invested a lot in a plant close to our head office in Wolfsburg in a city called Braunschweig.
What's your battery partner?
It's Panasonic, but And so the cells are from Panasonic. The assembly is done by us. And as you know, this is kind of a delicate issue, which a manufacturer masters or doesn't master, also with the software when there's a failure in the battery cell. So that is really the competence.
Also, like battery management software.
Yes. You know, we engineered the battery for the lifetime of the vehicle, and we give an 8-year warranty for that. And we don't expect that within that usage, the customer will notice anything of that. Yeah? So there is some, but it's in the minor percentage, which is not recognizable. You may be able to measure it, and it may depend on the usage of a battery. Some are more and less affected, but it's insignificant for the customer usage. And we have Mr. Hintze, a former colleague of mine, here also in a special booth over there in the barn to go into the more details of that. So in terms of the package, we launched the vehicle with a $299 lease and high content of the vehicle with Leatherette, aluminum wheels, navigation system, what is really important. And it's kind of a first to market. Within the Volkswagen Group, we start the charging here as 7.2 kilowatt AC charging. In Europe, the vehicle was launched with less than that, and now we are offering that feature also. So this higher charging capability was driven really through US requirements. And what's not here in the press briefing is we are also investing with our dealers in fast charging infrastructure. DC charging was really key. You can charge a vehicle in 30 minutes up to, 30 minutes up to 80%. So that's really key when you imagine you charge your vehicle at home, and we teamed up for that with Bosch. We offer a wall box installation at a very attractive price with our partner Bosch, who is also our partner in Europe. To install a wall box for AC charging 7.2 kilowatt at your home, at the customer's home. But then when you go for a longer distance in the LA or San Francisco Bay Area, LA metropolitan area, or New York, you can go much more distance by utilizing the dealer network and go to a dealer and have a quick charge, 15 minutes, a coffee, and off you go. And you can make a round trip around 200 miles on a day with an electric vehicle within your metropolitan area. So that having said, that's not all what we do on Golf. As you know from our Think Blue strategy, the sustainability is very important for us, and electric vehicle itself for the usage to be emission-free really makes only sense once you do a lot of services around it. And so we have teamed up with a carbon neutral program where there's reforestation so that you compensate for any emissions related to the manufacturing of the vehicle or the charging of the, using the power, production of the electric power of the vehicle. We also teamed up with a very established charge partner, a public charging partner, ChargePoint, over 18,000 charging stations nationwide available for our customer. You have a card, you zip it, slide it through, and you charge in public charging spots, and you have that also available on your app, and you know where you can charge. The wallbox installation I talked already about, which we feel is essential for the convenience of the use of the car. That is, takes about a 4-hour charge for a full charge at home. And we offer roadside assistance at no cost in case, unlikely case, somebody doesn't make it or overestimates the battery range. And there's no worry. It's a hassle-free, no questions asked. We just help the customer and get him charged. But I think by the experience we have, this is a rare case to happen for the customer. But we felt that's important to take the hassle out of this. So having said that, this year, next to the worldwide launch of the Jetta facelift, it's all about Golf in the US for us. The GTI was launched, the TDI was launched. We received from the media, you guys, very good feedback and awards, which we are very proud of. The eGolf is now assembling that family, soon to be on sale in around November. The rGolf and the Golf Station Wagon, Sport Wagon, will come in early 2015 with the TDI and the TSI. So there's much more on golf to come. We, as a company, have very high expectations, and you see that also on the let me talk about, and then I go back to the GTI. The next slide, you see that on the pricing we choose for the Golf family, the entry price is $17,995, which is a very, very aggressive price, for, and we choose that for the launch model. But we brought a lot of value also down in content for the regular car lines within, or trim levels within Golf. We brought down the diesel offer with a new trim level and entry trim level by $3,000. We added, or we have the 170 horsepower 1.2 TSI engine with 30 miles per gallon EPA, the TDI at 45 miles per gallon. And we offer a large trunk size, as I talked about in the segment, bigger than midsize sedans. And we are very proud of the IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus rating we achieved for that vehicle. So when you talk about the Golf overall and the Golf GTI, it's really all about, for us, in terms of quality, the package. It's big in terms of a hatch, where normally hatches are not offering that space. It's about the power we are offering with the Rise powertrains. The safety standard is top. It's class leading, coming with the Golf. The value story, bringing down the TDI by 1,400 in content adjusted, but also by just offering the low entry trim we haven't had before. It's about a $3,005 price ticket to drop for the TDI. And you heard about the importance of the TDI for us, so we expect also a big volume push from that move going into a new customer group here. The TSI down, content adjusted $2,200, and the GTI has a values increase of $700. Its price only was increased, sticker price, by $195. And then, of course, the MQB platform offers us a lighter structure, more fuel-efficient engines, and with that also emissions improvements. So the Touareg, that's our premium vehicle here in the US market. It has actually a class-leading towing capacity in its competitive set. We did investments in the front to have a more aggressive design look and appeal. We invested in some changes in the trunk, lid, tornado line was sharpened. We have new LED headlights, and we have a new set of wheel programs. That's for the exterior. For the interior, we also have improved the premium appeal of that vehicle further, and we added more features. So you have new materials, chrome, and you have the safety features, the blind spot monitoring, the lane assist, post-collision parking brake system, and front assist city emergency braking, ACC adaptive cruise control. So it's really a full module we are using here to support the premium position of the Touareg, going on sale as a facelift early 2015. Now Passat. Second biggest seller for us next to Jetta. It's in its runout year. We'll have next year GP, the facelift. GP, we call it internally, the facelift coming. And we did great efforts to continue with the Passat, the value story, and make the vehicle very attractive, adding the new TDI to EA 288 to the lineup with 150 horsepower. Upgraded by 10 horsepowers. We have a fuel economy at 44 miles per gallon with the TDI manual and 42 with the automatic. We also add more content to the entry vehicles, the S vehicle, and then some of you know the Wolfsburg edition, which is a value edition. We include the rear view camera and the premium infotainment system for Passat. Beetle, similar story, gets a new TDI, very attractive fuel economy, 41 miles per gallon, and for the coupe and the convertible is 40 miles. very important here also, we added the classic trim, and the classic trim allows us to go and reach down with a higher value offer in a different price segment. So we are starting with a coupe at 20,195 and the convertible at 25,995. And that includes navigation, leather, three-color ambient lighting, etc. So it's really listening to the dealers, to the customers, to make the Beetle here more attractive. And I think this really will be a vehicle we expect to be in the sweet spot of the market. For the CC and EOS, CC will receive new wheels. The EOS, in its final year, will have a run-out edition, a sport trim added, final edition with new wheels, with a two-tone interior, with some detailing of the stitching inside, the rear-view camera, and rain sensing to make it a very attractive offer. And then the Tiguan, again, a very important segment for us to play in. Again, we added content to the vehicle. We enriched the trim at the lower price range, offering now standard rear-view camera, Sirius satellite radio, roof rails, and then going with the premium touchscreen into the S and E, SE trim, along with the CarNet you heard already about. And remember, press the info button and not the SOS button. In summary, really, this event is about you looking at and driving, experiencing the facelift of Jetta, the key car for us here in the US, experiencing the e-Golf, which I'm really excited about. It's a global car for us. We are launching in multiple countries. And then, of course, looking at what we have done to the overall car line improvements, when you look at what we have done in terms of engineering, of quality, of fit and finish, and of the value story, that we offer a very attractive vehicle content at a very affordable price. That's, I think, something people expect from Volkswagen brand, and that's what we wanted to introduce you to today. So thank you very much.